Now, these are the chemical results for the transuranic paradox. Hahn and Stresemann decided to reinvestigate the evidence for radium. For chemical reactions, these could either be radium or barium. Since radium is an alkaline earth metal, therefore barium chemistry was employed to chemically segregate the supposedly radium activity. On the detection and the behavior of the alkaline earth metals produced by neutron irradiation of uranium contained the genetic sequence of isomeric chains, Hahn and Stresemann tried to separate radium from inactive barium. They carried out methods of fractional crystallizations and fractional precipitations, which are well known for concentrating or diluting radium in barium salt solutions. So BaBr2 increases the radium concentration significantly in the process of fractional crystallization. So some careful experiments were carried out to put this idea for radium to test, and separations were carried out using barium as carrier. So radium was suspected as a result of neutron bombardment of uranium. It was then treated with an acid. For instance, we take an example of HCl to obtain the corresponding chloride. So barium chloride was then added as a carrier solution to the assumed radium chloride solution, which was actually barium chloride. So this solution, which was now thought to contain both radium and barium ions, was made to react with carbonic acid to obtain radium and barium carbonates. Hydrogen bromide was then added to the solution of radium and barium carbonates to obtain their corresponding bromides. So the final step in this procedure was a fractional crystallization to separate barium carrier from the suspected radium. So because radium was known to co-precipitate preferentially with barium bromide, the ratio of radium to barium in the precipitate had to be higher than the ratio in the solution as a result of fractional crystallization process. To their surprise, Hahn and Stresemann observed the radium activities to be evenly distributed among the successive barium bromide fractions. Thinking something might have gone wrong with their experimental procedure, control experiments were conducted using the known radium isotopes. They performed a calibrated fractional crystallization that they called the indicator method. Since the activity in question could only be radium or barium, they were forced to conclude that the radium isotopes 1 through 4 were not radium but barium. So following up this finding, Hahn and Stresemann employed the indicator method also for actinium-2. The chemical conclusion was that actinium-2 was lanthanum. We come to the conclusion that our radium isotopes have the properties of barium. As chemists, we should actually state that the new products are not radium but rather barium itself. As chemists, we really ought to revise the decay scheme given above and insert the symbols Ba, La and Cb in place of radium, actinium and thorium. However, as nuclear chemists working very close to the field of physics, we cannot bring ourselves yet to take such a drastic step which goes against all previous experience in nuclear physics. There could perhaps be a series of unusual coincidences which has given us false indication.